Oh, I see. Why are you way over there, brother man? You switched microphones on me. Welcome to the Fro Daddy Show, Whoop 99.9 FM and WOOPFM.com. Every afternoon on this wild and crazy show. Tell them more about it.
Well, we're here to let you know it's just another day in paradise.
Thank you for waking up just in time to speak.
Well, ain't that too bad to do it. How you doing today, my brother?
Oh, I'm about fitty-fitty. How you hanging?
Well, a little to the right. Thank you.
No, I'm to the left.
Well, something's wrong with that picture.
You know, when I work out, I gotta shift it.
Oh, Spike.
I shifted into third gear, and you got to be careful, you know, when you're working out. Where are you way over there? And, man, I'm going to shoot you in the ass with a BB gun.
Oh, well, I'm going to tell mother, by God. You take that to the
hoop. There it is.
To the hoop.
Hey, we're out there on the internet, WOOPFM.com, and you can tune in, see us on the video cam all the way around the world. I got my hair greased back, just came in all sweaty from the gym. I don't know if y'all know, but we're down here in the Village Green Town Center.
Uh-huh.
I wonder, is that spelled Center?
It's 301.
Or Centra.
301 Keith Street.
We were talking, I was talking earlier
Norwegian.
About the difference in a theater and a theater. What do you call it? What do the people in the homies call it?
Theater is one, and theaters are many.
Yeah, I understand plural versus singular. A theater and theaters.
But
that's not what I said.
Also, rain in Spain stays mainly on the plane.
I didn't ask how many turds are in the toilet. I asked you, what is the difference in theater and theater?
Theater is the beginning of having a theater.
Oh, I see. So it's theatrics, but yes. Shortened to theater.
Correct, 4.17.
Oh, we are all thespians in one way or another, aren't we?
Let's not build a China wall.
Hey, is there some reason why you're behind me over there? Can you not sit over here like a white person?
No.
I mean,
I can't.
Fellow radio guy?
No, I'm sorry. I'm getting niggeroed. I'm running to the trees.
I changed my mind, by the way. I don't know if you guys have been listening.
Yeah, what's that?
Since I've been back in 2018. You know, I had to take a hiatus with my mom dying and the, home sales and... I had eye surgery, and it's just, you know, everything flops up on Tom, you know, like a big cow pile shat.
Tom Cruise.
And it, like a fly sitting there on a dog pile, and then the big dog comes along and poops right on top of me.
Magnum P.
I'm like a sandwich meat for dog poo.
Zeller Schwarzkopf.
Okay, you're going to randomly say words again today.
Yes, move on down the road.
I see you got your word book, so you shouldn't run out.
And do not mess with it.
There you go. And even phrases today. That's, you look like you're not on Comet.
Well, I have me some PMs.
And somebody said on Comet, on Blitzen, they were not being too facetious about you on Comet because you will snort it if there's nothing else.
Well, go on with it, 4.0.
So what I was saying before I was so rudely interrupted by myself in my miniature shadow was the fact that I had promised. Well, I didn't promise. I just said, don't forget to enjoy our show now because when we come back in 2018...
There'd be no blemish.
Fro Daddy had had several meetings with attorneys and some guys from the Cayman Islands and blah, blah, blah. But it turns out they weren't, one of them didn't show up and the board of director guy didn't take minutes. So, you know, being an LLC and all, that means it's illegal and the meeting didn't really count. And the paperwork I was handed, I threw in the garbage. I never opened it. But I was told there was all kinds of things in there that I was supposed to read and sign about. You know, things I can't say anymore to you and, you know, stupid crap. You know, like the S word and the F word and the N word.
Oh, really?
Guess what, folks? Stay tuned. Stay tuned because I had changed my mind with a little help from my leprechaun.
Say it again.
I said with a little help from my leprechaun, my chocolate bunny. I decided not to go the straight route for this season.
Now you're going to get to call me all those wonderful names again.
That's right, because I never got the memento and the momentum and the dividends and the portfolios and the...
are you speaking Cajun?
What's that thing over in Russia they're all in trouble about?
A dossier. A dossier?
Did you get your dossier for Monday's business yet?
No, I threw mine in the garbage on the way out.
I figured that's your brain is what you're saying, right?
What brain?
That's what I'm arguing about. You still got a brain stem. We did figure that.
Yeah, it lights up every once in a while.
Not really. Not like
well,
a lot.
Well, what about a mudslide in, California?
You're like plugging a piece of licorice into a light bright. It just really doesn't show up in the dark, does it?
Well, Fro, you know, you stand out like a sore thumb.
So what I'm saying is, folks, you know, if you've kind of enjoyed the show over the past 10, 20 years,
raise your right hand.
Well, it's going to be the same for this year because as long as my sidekick rambles on and doesn't eat the damn bowl of chili I brought him 2 days ago and it's rotten in the fridge.
Oh, it's already been had.
Oh, you did? When did you eat it? I noticed it was here yesterday.
I put it on some beef hot dogs.
What?
Honey, sit
down. Is that what you were going to the grocery store to get today?
I got me some beef hot dogs.
Let me guess. Did you get buns?
You didn't make that chili, did you?
Yeah. Did you get buns?
Hello?
Okay, you're going to have to go out there, brother. We can't let people in here. Random on, brother man. Yeah. So anyway, did you go get buns, mustard, and ketchup? Hey, what'd you get?
We got to shut the door, brother. You can't come in here like this.
Yeah. Man, we live. We got NAACP and the ISIS are coming in. Brother man had a shotgun to Matador's head. Yeah, he was going to take us all out. I thought we were goners. Anyway, Matador's a busy man. Matador, I thought that was one of your homies bringing you some more crack.
Well, I don't know if he's got a gun.
Well, we know, never know. So anyway, Matador, what I was telling you about was you went and bought all this stuff. What did you spend at the grocery today just to have my chili?
No, I got this the other week, Rodetti.
No, I just saw you crossing the road today with two bags from the Super Saver across the street, and I'm asking you what you got.
Well, I had I get my victuals.
Yeah, that's what I just asked you.
I got me
and
some.
And I said you probably got buns, mustard, potato chips.
No, I had all that, and I did the potato chips. I with my hot dog, and then I put some in it. I want to try some of your chili out on it.
Okay.
And I scared from 1 to 10. You was a 4.
Well, piss on you, buddy.
None taken.
Remind me not to ever bring you anything else.
But after I put the mustard on it, I would possibly give it a 5.
No, forget it, buddy. You're out. And just to think,
anything that's got beans in it, you keep it away from me.
Just think. Oh, trust me, I will. I don't even know why I brought that crap.
Anything with a bean in it, do not even try.
No pun intended. Uh-huh. Hey, I thought I'd go ahead and throw out there. I've mentioned this probably the last 6 or 8 shows of 2017. I mentioned all you have to do is come in here, Matador, and what do they have to bring? If they'll just bring it in here, I'll give them a free Whoop T-shirt. And what is it they have to bring?
That little, what do you call it? It's in the newspaper.
A little bitty ad.
Look, by one.
Look, I'm cutting it out. I'll put it on the camera in case you folks are, if there's one or two people even paying attention on the internet anymore. Here's our spot, and there's a logo in the Cleveland Daily Banner today.
Yeah, right.
And if you can bring that in there,
you can win $5,000 for a week for the rest of your life.
No, that's something else. That's another program.
Well,
we have a Pro Daddy and the Matador live, like your afternoons, a little on the strange side, and it's got our phone number, Whoop, or something, in the 330. And then it's got a little bitty logo. You know, the little jackass. You know, not you, Matador, but I'm talking about our logo. Little Whoopi.
Yeah.
You know Little Whoopi, don't you?
So they can win a T-shirt.
Yeah. Well, all they can do is show up. Just come down here. Walk in. And I'll have you run over there, and Daniel will give you a shirt, and they get a damn shirt. I'll tell you what. I'll give them two. One for them and one for their spouse.
Well, tell it like it is, brother.
I know. You know what a spouse is?
That's your spinaros.
That's your spooge partner.
Yeah.
But anyway, you know, and I'm not saying it's got to be man, woman, child, or
Watch it, he got a gun.
HGTV or whatever that is.
When I say duck, duck.
Did we ever resolve the issue of why the Ladies Professional Golf Association is so pissed off about not having their own bathrooms?
Well, it's because of the pendejos
that
wanted their own.
Oh, the Mexicans?
Those that had two things.
Oh, them things that do it to themselves.
Yeah, they got one in front, one in the back.
And they said, do it. Do it till you're satisfied, whatever it is. Come on and do it.
Till you're satisfied.
Do it.
Whatever
till you're satisfied. Even if it's to yourself.
Yeah.
Come in here. Matter of fact, you don't even have to bring a damn, don't even go home and buy a banner and look at the, find the, just come in here and tell us if you want a shirt.
Mm-hmm.
You know why? Because it's 12 degrees outside and, you know, it's a t-shirt. You're not going to wear it till spring anyway, so nobody
it's
wants
called
it.
Healing.
And I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to put an order in with Daniel. And what I'd like to do is order our sweatshirts. I'm going to order them about, I'm going to think, what do you think, end of April, middle of May, somewhere in there? Somewhere after, you know, the spring and is in the air and the heat has come around and everybody's wearing their little mini shorts over at Lee
That's
University.
That's what you think.
Girls are wearing their little tennis shorts, jumping
just
up and down.
Just wait till the weekend,
getting
bro.
Their underwear. And we're riding around peeking at it and you're running in stop signs like you did last year. Looking at that little boy over there on the basketball court. And then we're going to give, maybe you have a chance to win sweatshirts. That's the way we do it here. And we also have a Whoop Wednesday. So if you'll come in between now and Friday, anytime between 3:30 and preferably, you know, right before I'm trying to leave. Oh, you got to be here like at least before 4:30 or 4:45 because we have to go over to, they won't give me the shirts because my daughter gave them all away to Spongelica last time. Now we have no shirts large enough for a man, thanks to Spongelica getting all the 2Xs and 3Xs. But we do have some mediums and larges left for this miniature men and or small women. Well. I know there's some. Oh, I brought you a shirt, speaking of shirts. So what I'm saying is just get here before Friday and come in here and tell me you want two damn shirts and some window stickers, and you'll get everything you want. And Christmas comes late for us here. Mandor, did you see that shirt I brought you today?
Yeah. That ain't none of mine. It's a woman's shirt, man. You don't know it's your damn
No, life. I brought it to you because, see, it's got your initial R.
J.
No, yeah, it's R. C. J.
Oh, it's a short, but it's got a Christmas thing.
Yeah, and it's like a little Santa Claus hat. But I thought, you know, something you wear around the house, and it's got sparkly, and it's got your name. And then if you meet a hot chick with an R, you know, with an initial R, you can say you bought it for
now,
her.
Now, like Spongelica can get into that.
Well, I said if you met a hot chick.
She's
not a fat chick.
She's not fat. She's just big.
You know, lard, when lard gets fat, it melts and turns clear, doesn't it? It's not fat and wide anymore. It's kind of thin and clear. Boy, you'd be happy to know what I had for lunch today.
What was it?
Some chicken that I had broiled, and it was wonderfacus. And some broccoli and some noodles I had left over. And I have a whole vat of that chili I made, and guess what I'm going to do with it? I'm going to eat it for about 2 or 3 days, and I'm going to freeze it. Instead of bringing it to you, I'm just going to freeze the damn thing instead of bringing it to you.
Well, don't do that.
Oh, yeah, because you said you didn't. Yeah, it was a four.
Sugar in the morning.
Yep, it was a four, so you don't need.
You take coffee in the morning.
Hello, everybody. It is Horoscope Hump Day.
I asked your question,
when you call in with your song request today, get the added surprise and excitement of having your horoscope read to you from my brain to your ears from Fro Daddy, the horoscope soothsayer himself. And it's not spelled like you think. It's horoscope, W-H-O-R-E, scope. Matador gave me that idea about, when I met Spongelica. Anyway, it's hump day.
Hump day!
We're recording the show today, so if you're listening to this show and it is not January the 10th, 2018, don't call in because we ain't here, bitches. We are pre-recorded, and I do that because I'm planning on going out of town in about a month, Matador. And so I'm not going to tell management, and Daniel just plugs in a bunch of my shows, so, you know, when you're over here, you can just sleep the whole time.
Oh, I do tell it, then.
Tell it, people. And I asked you to do that, so you didn't again. I got you cut off. Anyway, we're going to do weather, traffic, keep you updated on the time and temperature today. Right now, it's exactly 3:50 p.m., and the temperature here in beautiful Cleveland, I got 3:51 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And the temperature here, before we get into our chief meteorologist with a full weather report, is 66 degrees right here in beautiful Cleveland, Tennessee. And the degrees in Old Fort, Tennessee, 66 degrees. As we go around the clock here, I'm going to all my listeners out there in Benton, Tennessee, up in Polk County, where they make that moonshine so fine, they are exactly 66 degrees. And in Athens, the northeastern part of the town on this side of the mountain, the hill there, that can pick us up. If you're up there on the hill, Wild Bill from Athensville, I think you passed away. You hadn't called me in a while. Drinking that Bud Light Platinum or Budweiser, whatever it is. Yeah, Bud Light Platinum he used to drink every night. I think the truck must have come unhooked while he was on his sixth beer and rolled back into the trailer, and I hadn't heard from him forever. Anyway, it's 66 degrees up there with you, Wild Bill, in Athensville. Coming around the horn here, going counterclockwise by map for Caucasianalistics that are paying attention. Going up through Decatur and Dayton, it is up there on beautiful Tennessee River, 65 degrees. That river brings it down. And then we swing back down through Sodomy Daisy. Sodomy Daisy is 65 degrees. They're down there on the river, you know. And plus, they're a little more south, and that cool wind's still coming this way. And then we bring it on up through our folks down in Ooltewa. Now, when you're down in Ooltewa, if you've noticed, if you're driving from Cleveland to Chattanooga and you go Ooltewa, you go through Ooltewa to get there. If you go over White Oak Mountain on the interstate, about the top of the interstate, and, you know, when you top the White Oak Mountain, you go down the other side, the Jesus Christ Church of the Latter Saints of Whoop Jehoshaphat's station comes in, and you'll go from hearing Matador talk about elephant masturbation to the Matthew 5:13 or something, and it'll scare the hell out of anybody in the car that listens to gospel or Christian information. So if it's that the case, then I would suggest you not put it on 99.9 when you top the hill. Why make not? Sure you turn it off before.
It's because if you're
used to listening to our program and you all of a sudden hear a Christian program or gospel music, it will scare the hell out of you. And, of course, that's why we play a lot of gospel here, to kind of bleed it in, get you prepared. So as you come on up to there in Charleston and, come around and I think we've got everybody. It's 66 degrees. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And I've talked for 25 minutes. It's now 5:13. We have to go. Matador, say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. So anyway, Matador, I got some stuff I want to talk about. Are you listening?
Yeah, go ahead.
What do you want to talk about?
Work.
I know you love words. So anyway, things to talk about and entertain the folks before we just play some music here on Horoscope Hump Day. And we've already gone over the weather. Of course, we'll have traffic a little after 5 as usual. We got the Tennessee Sandhill Crane Festival coming up Saturday and Sunday, and we'll talk about that a little later on. It is Horoscope Hump Day. Mm-hmm. You get a free T-shirt if you just call in and, whatever. Or come in, whatever. We'll give you one, if we have any. I was thinking about it, Matador. It's the America's most active. I saw a list in a Gallup survey, and I know you love surveys, and you take a lot of polls, and you don't give many, but you take some. These towns that they Gallup polled, they said who in what towns exercise at least 30-plus minutes or more, 3 times a week or more. And from 2008, they've been watching this, a cross-section of 177,000 American adults in all these towns, and they came up with these towns that are the top 10 most active cities in America. Are you ready?
Go ahead.
Number one, Boulder, Colorado.
Woo, Colorado.
I have a feeling they're going to drop off the list as soon as that weed starts going through the town there. And Fort Collins, Colorado is number two. Now, guess this. Now, Greeley, Colorado is number four.
Wow, Colorado's got it.
Yeah. Well, guess what? Colorado is one, two, and four. San Luis Robles, California is three. Santa Rosa, California is five. Honolulu, urban Honolulu, Hawaii is six.
What?
Yep. Now, get that. Now, Chico, California is 10. So, almost all of the top 10. Hey, girl, Maisha. Come in here and bounce that basketball for me.
What a potato chip.
Look, there's a dark-skinned girl.
Sure is. Look at that.
She got that blonde hair, too.
Hey, her name is Catherine.
Anyway, so, no, it's not.
Jay.
So, get this, Matador. So, think about it. All the...
I tried.
Let me cut him off before I can finish this story. So, the most active towns in America previous to today, or to the passing of the legalized marijuana in Colorado and California, they were the top six most active cities out of 10. Guess what? When we do this survey in the next few years, I have a feeling those folks won't be there anymore. Wonder why.
Hey, man, give me some potato chips.
Right.
Get up and turn the TV. I forgot the remote, man. Mm. Hey, the police are after us. I'm moving town.
Shutter.
Man, I'm tired of the man. The man's after me all the time because he wants me to work or something.
Shadow.
Man, you got any more hits on that thing? Man, go get me some more weed, man.
Well.
Hey, when you go get some Airheads and Mountain Dew, would you? I haven't eaten breakfast today.
So anyway, get this, Matador. You know what my favorite part, though, when I was doing my research?
Uh-uh. What was it? Do not swallow.
I'm gonna give you a hint.
Oh, save a monkey and his best.
Nope. My favorite research when I was doing this search about the most... most active cities in America, in the United States, between California and Colorado, guess who was number nine?
Tennessee.
Clarksville. Well, Tennessee's a state, but you're close. Clarksville, Tennessee was the only town in Tennessee to make the list, which is amazing that anything in Tennessee made the list. But you know, Tennesseans, we're workers. The reason I'm doing this little monkey sound effect, my daughter, is you remember...
That's not a monkey.
What is it?
That there, my boy, is what you call a yellow-bellied sapsucker.
Is it? I thought a yellow-bellied sapsucker was a rutabaga.
That's a bird.
I mean, what is it? It's a bird?
Yes. Yellow-bellied sapsucker.
No, this is the feeding sound of a monkey.
Oh, no, that boy's living it. He's loving it, ain't he? Come along home, Cindy, and I'll marry you someday.
Yeah, that makes sense. Anyway, Matador, it reminded me of Clarksville in Tennessee. Can you believe Clarksville, Tennessee, number 9 in the America's most active towns? Now, I have a feeling it's skewed a little bit because there's only like 7 adults there at any certain time, and 6 of them are playing golf.
Hey, quit that, man.
In the Clarksville, golf course over in Clarksville. And the other person works there. So, yeah, nobody lives in Clarksville. So it's kind of, percentages are wrong, but.
Where are you going with that?
Yeah. Well, anyway, so it's Clarksville, Tennessee. What can you do? And there's monkeys everywhere. So I thought this would be a good song for all you active folks in Tennessee. Give it up for Clarksville, Tennessee. And don't start smoking that pot. You can be here by 4:30, cause I've made your reservation. Don't be slow. I'm a no-no, I'm a no-no, cause I'm leaving in the morning, and I must see you again. We'll have one more night together, till the morning brings my train and I must go. I'm a no-no, I'm a no-no, and I don't know if I'm ever coming home. Take the last train to Clarksville, I'll be waiting at the station. We'll have time for coffee, flattered kisses, and a bit of conversation. Oh, no, 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 oh, no, no, no. Take the last train to Clarksville. Now I must hang up the phone. I can hear you in this noisy railroad station. All alone, I'm feeling low. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. And I don't know if I'm ever coming home. Take the last train to Clarksville and I'll meet you at the station. You can be here by 4:30, cause I've made your reservation. Don't be slow. I'm a no-no, I'm a no-no, and I don't know if I'm ever coming home. Yeah, take it, Mendo. Mendo, you ever been to Clarksville, Tennessee?
Yes, I have.
Do you know what group that was that just sang that song, by the way?
The Beatles, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was the Beatles. That's why I played those monkey sounds earlier. I thought you'd catch that.
Well.
How hard is it to get a DJ to come help me in here, I wonder?
Well, you just have to put your face in it, Brody.
That's what I was thinking, but probably not.
Give me a backwards flip.
I'm not going to be that lucky, am I? Hey, anyway. All the cities in Colorado and California that were listed on this past survey they did from the Gallup poll, and of 177,000 American adults, 6-7 out of the 10 cities were from Colorado and California, and they're not going to be there.
All right, again.
It's just like you. When you get drunk, you can't pay attention to what I'm doing. Neither can people smoking weed.
Well, I just moved.
And that was
way.
The monkeys, Matador, but you were close. The Beatles, the monkeys, same thing. One's an insect and one's your ancestor.
And they tell me you ain't got one in your family.
Everybody's got one in the tree, yeah. If you like bananas. Except you call them boo-nanas. Why is that, yellow-bellied sucker?
I like banana boo-nana pudding.
Oh, is that why you call them boo-nanas? Because you like boo-nana pudding?
That's what it's. That's how you spell
hey,
boo-nana.
Pudding-tane. Ask me again. I'll tell you the train.
Yes, you did.
What'd you say?
Checkmate. You like chicken sandwiches?
No. We'll be back in a minute. No food for the rest of the day. I gave you chili. You didn't eat it. Goodbye. You gave my chili a 4. We're not talking about food anymore.
Chill,
I'm never bringing you food. Oh, by the way, I was smoking some ribs over the weekend, so thought I'd let you know that since I'm not bringing you.
Oh, is that good? You wouldn't bring them one.
I ain't doing nothing.
Dr. Christopher Chase, with Associates in Plastic Surgery, now offers his patients the convenience of a Cleveland office at 2350 North Okoy Street. Dr. Chase specializes for the ladies in breast augmentation, including lifts, reconstructions, and reductions. Also, tummy tucks or mommy makeovers, and facial rejuvenation, including facelifts, eyelids, brows, nose, and he also offers Botox procedures. Check out Dr. Christopher Chase. He is certified by the American Board of Surgery, the American Board of Plastic Surgery. He's a member of the American Society of Plastic Surgeons and the American Society of Aesthetic Plastic Surgery. Check their website out at aprs.md. That's aprs.md. Call for your convenient appointment in Cleveland at 624-0021. 624-0021. 2350 North Okoy. That's Dr. Christopher Chase.
No dealers allowed.
Jackson Catnapper. Family owned and operated in Cleveland since 1933, offering the best with over 70 styles of recliners, sofas, electronic lift chairs, full living room packages. Call Mike now at 961-7239 because Jackson Catnapper now offers sales to the public
every Saturday. That's right, every Saturday.
From 8 in the morning to 1 in the afternoon. Or call Mike at 961-7239. Or go see him
every Saturday
at 1911 King Edward Avenue, just across from the main plant. Jackson Catnapper, family owned and operated in Cleveland since 1933. 961-7239.
No dealers allowed.
Back, we remember a Mississippi blues legend tonight, also known as the Blues Queen. Belzona native Denise LaSalle passes away at the age of 78. Delta News' Mara Scott has more on her legacy.
Blues legend, R&B singer, record producer. The Queen of the Blues, Denise LaSalle, leaves a legacy for all to remember. LaSalle died late Monday evening after battling a heart condition.
Queen of the blues, no longer the queen of soul blues. And now the legacy is going to be left to those of you who have picked up the torch and those of you who will pick the torch up in the future. What a legacy Denise LaSalle have left behind.
Blues singer and artist Bobby Whelan talks of the times they shared as friends, describing her as one of his idols.
The greatest. I mean, and she was original too. She wasn't one of those singers that tried to sound like somebody else. She was Denise. When you hear Denise start singing, you know it's Denise. I don't care what the words are. And so she was original, and it's a loss to Belzona, and it's going to take us a big shoe to fill, somebody to fill Denise, fill the shoes of Denise LaSalle.
Although she moved from Belzona as a teen, LaSalle never forgot where she came from, performing at numerous festivals, including the 2017 Mississippi Delta Blues and Heritage Festival in September. LaSalle had just gotten out the hospital the day before and was told she didn't have to perform, but she said she could handle it, and she did. One of her nephews tells the Delta News that she's most famous for blues, but his favorite was her love for gospel.
He has left a legacy in blues music. She has also left a legacy in gospel music. Even though she sang the blues, the good news is that she knew Jesus Christ. She talks about in one of her songs how people will love to come to her show and hear them talk about man. She says she's still talking about a man, but this man is Jesus.
LaSalle has a blues marker in Belzona in front of the Humphreys County Courthouse. Whelan painted a picture of her that is on display at the Museum of Mississippi History. LaSalle's funeral will be held Saturday in Memphis, and a memorial service will be held in Belzona on Friday. Time and place will be announced as it becomes available. In Belzona, I'm Mara Scott.
Matador, are you going to go to Denise LaSalle's funeral?
No, I won't get to make it, bro. I'm going to be tied up.
Oh, man, I was hoping you'd go with me.
Yeah.
You know, she got that song, Trapped by a Thing Called Love. Anyway, Denise LaSalle, R&B singer-songwriter, died in Jackson, Tennessee. She knows she had that to hit. And she had a couple other things, like back in the early 70s, at 78 years old. I was thinking about her because I saw where she had passed away. And that boy on there, he said it just right, Matador. She had some big shoes to fill.
She's a good sailor.
She likes sponge jackets. She sure filled them up.
Well, not in Texas.
But, you know, she knew Jesus, so I don't want to talk bad about her because Lord knows we don't need any other help around here. Along with Trapped by a Thing Called Love, she was also known for the song Now Run and Tell That. She had a bunch of little songs back in the 70s. And anyway, Mississippi native. Let's do one in her honor, though. That bold and baldest style she had, that sexy self, that big old shoe size 12 voice. And here's Trapped by a Thing Called Love in honor of Denise LaSalle passing away.
And I'm hooked on anything
Yeah, man, what a singer. Big shoes to fill, too, now that she gone. Lord, SpongeBob could fit in those, I guarantee.
No, let's not go there.
Well, I can't help it. I wouldn't go there for sure.
Bob White?
No, I wouldn't go there.
Have you ever heard of Ichabod White?
Yeah, is that Ichabod Crane's
brother? I said Ichabod White.
Oh, no, tell me about it.
Well, he was a great philosopher. Ichabod White, he played a very important role back in the days when he was a character. He was telling hide from the British that the British were coming, and they went to Ichabod White to pass the word on to the Crusoe brothers, who then came up with the idea to let the pounds people know that the British were coming, and he was Ichabod White.
How are you spelling that?
Ichabod White?
Yeah.
N-I-G. A-B-O-B-W-H-I-T-E.
Ichabod shit.
Yeah. Ichabod White.
I think you left the W out, didn't you? You say S-H-I-T?
No, that's W-H-I-T-E.
Oh, okay. Ichabod. Ichabod White. Bob White?
Bob Ichabod?
Tell me, Rochester. How do you get away with that? See, if I did that in my door, the NAACP is a terrible thing.
No, it's N-I-G.
You're a terrible time of my life.
A-B-O-B.
Okay, we've already gone past that. We're moving on to something else, if you can pay attention.
All right.
Thank you, man. It's Horoscope Hump Day, Matter. What do you want to hear today?
I want to hear my horoscope. Did I believe it?
No, I don't do your horoscope.
Well, I do.
Put your teeth back in. I can hear them rattling.
Well, they move around when they hurt. That's amazing, isn't it?
Hey, we need to call
Big Mike. Like a Mexican jumping bean.
We need to call Big Mike over at Jackson Catnapper this afternoon. How late do you think he'll be there?
Yeah, let's see what's happening with old Mike.
We need to call Big Mike. My sister wanted to buy a couch and a love, you know, a sectional. She said, I saw one that's red and I want it. And I said, I'll call Big Mike, see if it's still there. We'll go get it.
Yes, dude.
I may take you out there Saturday. The problem is we moved a bunch of stuff in our room and now there's nowhere to put it and now we can't go get it yet. But we'll figure something out. All right, go pump day, my door. It's Wednesday, the January the 10th, 2018. If you're tuned in the new season here on the Fro Daddy Show, this is a pre-recorded show. If you're listening and it's not January the 10th, 2018, if you are, it's about 12, 13 minutes after the hour, 4 p.m. Eastern right here in Cleveland, Tennessee. And we are live in the studio, the green room here. For some reason, we painted the entire studio green.
I wonder
do you remember why we did that?
Well, it showed that the cameras can make it look...
Yeah, well, like, but there's only a 3-foot section on the video, so I'm not sure why we did that.
It's living color.
I think we should paint you green so nobody sees you here. And
that's
they don't,
all they need to see me. Why don't you tan paint it green?
See your teeth come out.
Everybody would want to pull on me.
Hey, don't forget it is the Tennessee Sandhill Crane Festival this Saturday and Sunday. And in honor of Bad Actor, didn't he take you over there a couple times and you got in trouble for shooting one of the eagles that they were showing how it flies back and forth to the trainer and you shot it?
No, we just got a chance
you did
to
something to it.
You
might have tried to hit it or something, but I guarantee you there was some guy mad at you and said y'all weren't welcome back.
Yeah, I'm going to pull some feathers out of an eagle.
That's what it was. You were wanting an eagle. You plucked a little eagle
and
feather.
He told me not to do that. It was against the law.
I said, he didn't need it. Well, Matt Dora, I was thinking about, we got the Sandhill Crane Festival coming on this Saturday and Sunday right here in beautiful Hiwassee Refuge area. Wildlife Refuge. Tell me about the story where you got thrown out with Bad Actor for going to the Sandhill Crane Festival. He took you up there to be nice, and you first thing you did is wander over and tried to pluck an eagle feather and got in real big trouble. Tell us what happened.
Then they were showing us some of the local birds out in Arizona, the state birds, and they showed us a variety of hawks.
Yeah, I'm more interested in you getting in trouble over trying to pluck an eagle feather.
No, we got in trouble when he wanted food right then, and took him too long, and he snatched a waitress up.
Oh, you talking about Bad Actor?
Yeah.
Oh,
and he said, you're going to have to speed it up in there. I'm kind of hungry. He snatched the poor little boy up real bad.
I heard him pop a boy up there at the chef up here on 64 Highway, or what's that place called?
Yeah.
Y'all pulled in and he yelled at some old boy.
Yeah, no.
I was really talking about the Sandhill Crane Festival, if you remember.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. Just one of those amazing moments with the Dudley.
Do you know how to get there? If I let you go right now on your mini bike, could you meet me there?
At the hamburger place?
Well, tomorrow we'll be talking about... somebody, anybody out there interested in being an assistant DJ?
You got the
really
right
use
one
a,
now.
Use a co-host here. Like Ricky Bobby Roy's cousin says, Fro, you could get some good help in there. I know, Ricky. If we only could have had some money. Anyway, I was wanting you to tell the story about Sandhill Crane, but you're going to not tell it because you got in damn trouble for getting an eagle feather and you stuck in your hat and walked out of there. And y'all had to leave the premises. And I think Bad Actor was mad at you for a long time because they thought, kind of made him look bad. And he loves the birds.
He just told me to go pick up one and snatch one of them off an eagle. And I just did it. I didn't know it was against the law to have snatch an eagle feather.
But I realized, it wasn't that so bad except you hit it in the head with a brick first.
No, I just went up and snatched him, stirred that cage up a little bit. He let go of a few of them, but he didn't let go of the big strong one. So I had to grab him one time. He just squealed when I pulled one out and looked at me like I was crazy. So that was some of us party on.
I'm hoping. So what I want to do is pick you up. But we're going to go up Saturday. And I want you to go because I've got a little, I've got somebody going with me and they're going to video. And I want you to do that again because I want to get it on video.
Okay. I'll never do that again. I know better now.
I talked to him.
And fine over $500.
No, really, I talked to him and they said it was okay this time for you to come up because we're planning it and it's going to be a comedy thing. And it's okay. I'm going to video it, though. But it's, we're going to act like nobody knows about it, so you go ahead and, you can do it and nobody will know, okay? I'll be there to get you about, 10 a.m. Is that okay?
That'll work.
All right. Sandhill Crane. I wonder, why do they call them the Sandhill Crane?
Because they lived on the sandhills. That's where they mostly...
That is what in the sandhills?
Because they stayed a lot on the sandhills. Sandhills out in the creeks. Out in the places where they'd be. They just have thousands of them together on these sand hills years ago. That's thousands.
Sandy hills? Where are they?
On these sand hills.
Yeah, Sand Hill. I'm assuming it means
these
sand.
These are the sound mounds that was out in the
sound
area.
Mounds.
Sand mounds.
Sand mounds. Why aren't they the sand mound cranes?
So back then, the Indians decided to call them a Sand Hill crane. Because
what Sam Hill are you even talking about?
Well, I'm talking about a Sand Hill crane by that.
Well, go ahead and finish.
Booker T. Washington.
Once you finish, we'll play some music for the peoples.
All righty. Then Archibob. It's Archinob.
Archibald Crane.
Archinob University.
What about Nickabob and Ichabob?
All right, Nickabob White.
Is that only at Christmas time that you talk about your aunt, uncle? Uncle
Nickabob? Would you like some to earn your plumage today?
Look here, Uncle Ben. I don't like white rice.
I like brown rice.
Hey, did you watch the Tennessee Vols last night?
Yeah, they got whooped again, didn't
they? Nah, you... Yeah, football's over there, Matador. I'm talking about that.
Did Marcedi get another 27?
I'm talking about the men. I know you.
Marcedi, is that a name?
Well, it's the Lady Vols, but I'm talking about the Tennessee men played last night. They beat Vanderbilt.
Well, what?
Vanderbilt.
Well,
they were down 10 at half, and I'm like, are you kidding me? I'm having to work on stuff on the house, just having it in the background. And then I turn around, I'll be damned if they didn't fight back, and it was tied up with just a minute to go. And I thought, oh, it was a wild, exciting score, but. Ended up beating them right there at the end. Wrench ran the hell out of them and beat them by 8 points, I think. Anyway, Tennessee's like, you know, the men are number 24, I think, now. And they had just beaten Kentucky. You know, Kentucky came to Knoxville and they beat them. I mean, you know, it's hard to beat Kentucky. And
Kentucky, Tennessee's going to get into some serious business.
You know, they don't have that boy Stokes anymore. You know, Casey Stokes is an illegitimate cousin they don't talk about.
Oh, really?
And, Stokes moved on to the pros, but they got this other boy named, his name's Admiral. Admiral. Are you awake?
I'm trying to.
Why don't you lean forward where I can see you and hear you when you talk?
I'll move that neck a little bit now, don't you, colored boy? Come on, lady.
Listen, I'm colored, okay, and I'm proud. There's no point in making fun of it.
Colored dude. Come on in, man with many colors.
You know the rule. Yeah. I was born pink.
Yep.
Turned red.
When you get hot, you turn red, and when you get cold, you turn blue.
I got blue.
And white.
And then I'll be brown when I'm burnt in the sun. And then I'm black when I'm dead and decayed. See, I got more colors than you. Don't be trying to pull that brown crap over on me.
Well, we'll
be
there.
You just one color.
Yeah, and it's solid.
See, that's why when I say, yeah, I'm a colored man, and they beat me up in school over and over and over.
Have you ever seen a colored woman with black chaps?
And you know what?
Black freckles.
You know what, though? My mother finally took me out of that
black school. That was one now. Look.
My mother finally took me out of that black school.
Shot who?
She finally took me out of the black school and put me back in a white school.
Yeah, I know. That's why you keep them knots on your head for some strange reason.
Because I kept saying, I'm colored and I'm proud.
Yeah.
What's up, girl? Look, it's Papisha.
Hello.
No, Tamisha.
Her name is
well, Matador doesn't know. What up?
Hey!
Listen, it's basketball season. No, you skipped the whole season, didn't come see us. Now it's basketball season. You can't come see us again.
Yes, I can come and see you.
Look out, girl. I'm going to get you on camera.
No, don't put me on camera.
Oh, yeah. Lord, I got to get that on there.
I want to shout out to my crew.
Hey, let me see. Is that hair real?
No, it's fake.
Oh, I like it.
Don't you
like
try it? To pull it.
See, I tell Medor I want to get a weave.
I like to take it up and swing it around. That's Lord, what I like.
Yeah. And Medor said, I bet you could take Medor and swing him around.
Yeah,
Matador, hey.
You'd put a hurting on him.
Things come in little packages, don't it, Matador?
Well, I ain't holding anymore.
Well, I wouldn't go that far.
I used to hold.
Y'all going to get me.
It's not like a woman where you pull them thing out in that girdle and then some. Wah, 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 wah. Matador, you pull his pants, it's like.
You hear it.
Laughing at me.
He is hilarious.
Hey, see you're
glad to meet you.
See you, Moesha.
Yeah, you're putting on.
Hey, if you're Tamisha. Hey, Matador. Matador, if. Matador, you don't tell a girl she's getting big.
Well, you tell they don't. Color girls don't smack you when you tell them they're getting big.
They proud of it.
It's the difference. Yeah, big. What dog do you know? Like,
listen. Listen.
You don't like meat on your bones?
Hey, I had an old girl. She didn't like meat, but she sure liked a bone.
Oh my God.
That boy.
Oh.
Rabbit. Rabbit.
There goes Tamisha. Our in-house. Black voice for the black women in the house.
There is.
Whatever happened to our HR girl that was a black girl? She got ran out of here.
See, you scared. She said, I'm scared of him. He's crazy. I said, honey, just shoot a spitball at me, well, lad.
She came
and
here,
then you in there.
She came here trying to give me that look, and I came right back with that EFing, you know, back and forth, and she got a little pale. She turned high yellow almost.
No, she just turned brown.
No, I thought maybe that was the one they implanted
maybe,
over here.
Maybe, baby, how you doing?
See, I think they were the one that they planted her over here from HR to get you in trouble for your sexual harassment.
Oh, man, you can't pet nobody on the butt no more. That's,
that's what I told you. Hey, let's go back to sports. Speaking of sports, you know, Tamisha's son, Cece, isn't it? Is it Cece? KK.
KK.
See, I wanted to say KKK, but they wouldn't let me.
Yeah.
See, KK Curry? I mean, CC. Yeah, KK Curry.
KK.
I said, is Curry spelled with a K? And they're like, no, you little bastard.
Yeah, K.
Because I was going to call him Triple K. But that probably wouldn't go so well. How's he doing? Is he still playing or is he graduated?
Well, no, he went to, he's playing somewhere upstate, man.
Oh, he gone. It's not the Tennessee.
He went to a college upstate.
So. Oh, not a prison. Okay. You say he went upstate. That means usually he went to prison.
Downstate is prison.
Oh, okay. Down school. He's downtrodden with the downstates. Anyway, Tennessee Vols won. I was excited about that. That took me about 10 minutes to almost fall asleep.
Or did you win anything off of it, brother?
Oh, I told you I lost that money.
Oh,
money gone, bitches. So anyway, we got some Dr. Livingston will be in here in a little bit, probably a little bit after 5. We got some Dr. Livingston's got some questions from the internet. We're going to have him answer. I saw him out there a little while ago. You know, he comes in on Wednesday nights for you know, group therapy and anger management, and they have the blessing of the Whoopsters and all that in honor of Miss Norma and her son passing away.
Bible study tonight.
Yeah, yeah, and the elders.
I'm going to go over with the elders. Psychiatrist meeting. Anger management is on hand today, too.
Mm-hmm. That sounds
good. Now I need to go to anger management because I have been very bad here lately.
I'll tell you
very
what, since I've decided to give up on my being nice, I've decided to give up on being nice for 2017, and going into 2018, I was going to just be a normal, boring-ass radio DJ.
Well, it won't be long.
And not talk bad about you, not use it, nothing.
Well, you'll have a tooth missing, or I'll ring around.
I don't give a damn, because you come in here yakking over me all the time and messing my show up. And so in that case, and you don't eat my damn chili I brought you, you don't give a crap about the smoked meat I make, you pour ketchup on.
And I didn't put anything in it, neither. Nothing.
I don't give a crap.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, speaking of music, out of Memphis, I was reading about the, you know, have that blues music nominees, you know, where people get inducted into the Blues Foundation, all that.
Uh-huh.
And they have that, and they got that Memphis in May where they have the barbecue contest. Oh, my God. All those good groups, you know, Rendezvous Ribs, all those people are over there. And, of course, all the brothers in the hood come out and they all barbecue and have contests. Memphis in May is fun, man, if you like to eat barbecue. But anyway, they have music and blues. I was noticing Taj Mahal, you know, we play some Taj Mahal here. Mavis Staples.
Oh.
Remember Mavis?
Yeah, what was that song she made?
Well, if all I was black, I'm going to play that one for you in a minute. But North Mississippi All-Stars, they're getting inducted. Nominees, anyway. Now, Kenny Wayne Shepherd, he's a white boy. But he can play. He's a white boy. He can play the guitar, boy. I've seen him now. Wee Willie Walker. I got some Wee Willie I might play for you. Eric Estrin. They got the Blues Music Awards. They had just announced that Monday, Blues Foundation. They're going to present awards May 10th at the Memphis Cook Convention Center. That's right in there with the Memphis in May, brother man. Mm-hmm. Hey, don't forget the past winners that received nominations this year. Curtis Salgado, De Una, Greenleaf, and Lurie Bell and Bobby Rush. You know Bobby Rush. But anyway, here's Mavis Staples with If All I Was Black. Goes out to all my folks that love that blues, that real blues. Comes from the heartland. Yeah.
If all I was black, looking at you, you might look past all the love I give.
Got love to give.
I've got natural gifts.
Got natural gifts.
Got perspective.
You want to
Door on the bongos. You did a fine job, man. Nothing.
If all I was black, don't you want to know me more than that? All the love I give,
got love to give,
got natural gifts,
got natural gifts.
I've got perspective,
got perspective. It's time for more love. Mm. Oh, it's time for more love.
Staple in the Blues Committee Convention Association of America. Good luck in her nominations and for the Blues Music Awards in Tennessee coming up in, I believe it's May 10th. Anyway, be cool. And Mundo, how'd you think about it? Mundo, what'd you think about Mavis's song?
She's alive, bro. She's one of a kind.
I was just didn't mean to wake you up.
Oh, nothing to
it. Let's move on to something else.
It's just one of those days.
Yeah, Mavis Staples. Hey, man, got love to give. I could have sworn I heard you playing bongos, but now you're asleep, man. How can man be on stage playing bongos, and then 20 seconds later be snoring?
Concentrate, bro.
And why do I ask? Because you do it every day on my show.
I'd like to have some fries with that chicken.
Yeah, we're moving on to something else.
And give me an extra order fries.
No, you're not getting crap from me, so don't even ask.
Well, you're going to pay for them, ain't you, by that?
Nope.
All right, then. Must call. Cleveland Airs. I'd like to say to you all, have an evening. Have a pleasant evening out there today.
I appreciate that.
But, you know, I wasn't the oldest one that got up like I was sore this morning.
You were
you
the
sore?
Oldest one?
Hi, Belly. Were you sore?
I don't believe I'd say that on the radio.
Hi.
Oh, where were you sore?
From head to
toe. I'm sorry, I misunderstood you. You're sore where?
From head to toe.
Oh, I see. You, okay, I thought something else the way you were standing.
No, I didn't get whooped by a pimp.
Okay, you were standing a little funny there. I didn't know.
It's a fundraiser, and I kind of wound up with a few bucks, extra bucks in my pocket. And a
fundraiser? Yeah. Oh, you were gambling.
Yeah, we was having Spongelica get her airline ticket to Chicago.
I don't think you were.
Well, we can do it over in Negrosville. We help each other.
So you're fundraising for a ticket to get her to go back to Chicago, but she's already in Chicago, so I don't know your point.
And I took a couple of bucks out, and then that's when the fight got started.
Oh, you stole from the kitty.
Yes, I did. $2 ain't nothing. I just put it in my pocket where I could get me a soda.
I bet they don't call you $2 Chuck. I bet it rhymes with it.
It's Tupac Cherie.
About 2 foot tall.
Hey.
Root.
That really makes me mad, brother.
Well, you can't help it.
No,
little whoop. You was like Gaga. You was bone that way.
Zsa Gabor.
No, Lady Gaga. But thanks for understanding.
Was that a man or a woman? Gaga.
I don't know.
Lady Gaga.
But she would make my job so much easier.
I'm not playing with that one on the internet.
I'm not playing with a full deck either. But that's not none of my business.
Hey, Brad actually taught me how to use that.
Yeah, I'm sure he did.
Internet.
Did he? Yeah, well, trust me, why don't you come over here and play on the internet for me?
Are you serious?
You said you had
to do it all the time.
There goes Johnny B. Jonesy.
Hello?
He's going to do the scooter dance.
Scooter who?
Hey, man, we're going to come back, play a little song. We'll come back, take a little break, come back. We got some, I see our chief meteorologist. Looks like he just came in. He's head back to the Dr. Christopher Chase, plastic surgeon, weather desk. Dr. Christopher Chase, associates in plastic surgery. That's their weather desk. Some reason they're sponsoring our weather station this week, our weather, and you know, we have award-winning weather reporter here, so he's our chief meteorologist. We're very proud of Randall S. Jarrett. He'll be back shortly, so stick around. But first, let's hear Wee Willie Walker. I'll mention him earlier because he is also a nominee for an inductee into the Blues Music Awards in Tennessee, if you know what I mean. Under, do you understand what blues, what I'm talking about? Music and everything. Okay, well, here's a little Wee Willie Walker with "There Goes My Used to Be." Just like my career in radio.
There goes my used to be. Oh, walking down the street. Saying hello to every guy she meets. Oh, they just don't know. Oh, she'll break their heart. How do I know? She wants broke.
This one goes out for Dangerous Dan from right there in Prospect. First time caller today. I don't lie, I mean to let anybody down, if you know what I mean. Yeah, Walmart.
Check out mine. somewhere's Queens. There's 400 items on the card in front of me. All the three lanes open, there are 20 items or less. 40 people in one damn lane, our cashier just left. 30 lanes in every store, they only open three. An angry line is wrapped around the hearts of bread and flat screens. Kid is somewhere screaming, I'm about to lose my mind. I feel like a hostage in a Walmart checkout.
Walmart checkout line. There's, quit making fun of the Walmart people. Yeah, they can't help if they dress like that.
Dr. Christopher Chase, with Associates in Plastic Surgery, now offers his patients the convenience of a Cleveland office at 2350 North Okoye Street. Dr. Chase specializes for the ladies in breast augmentation, including lifts, reconstructions, and reductions. Also, tummy tucks or mommy makeovers, and facial rejuvenation, including facelifts, eyelids, brows, nose, and he also offers Botox procedures. Check out Dr. Christopher Chase. He is certified by the American Board of Surgery, the American Board of Plastic Surgery. He's a member of the American Society of Plastic Surgeons and the American Society of Aesthetic Plastic Surgery. Check their website out at aprs.md. That's aprs.md. Call for your convenient appointment in Cleveland at 624-0021. 624-0021. 2350 North Okoye. That's Dr. Christopher Chase.
No dealers allowed.
Jackson Catnapper, family owned and operated in Cleveland since 1933, offering the best with over 70 styles of recliners, sofas, electronic lift chairs, full living room packages. Call Mike now at 961-7239 because Jackson Catnapper now offers sales to the public
every Saturday. That's right, every Saturday.
From 8 in the morning to 1 in the afternoon. Or call Mike at 961-7239. Or go see him
every Saturday
at 1911 King Edward Avenue, just across from the main plant. Jackson Catnapper, family owned and operated in Cleveland since 1933. 961-7239.
No dealers allowed.
Looks like Dr. Lewis is wandering through getting ready for his Wednesday night. He comes in and works on his program on Wednesday, Monday. Dr. Lewis, can you come in quick? We had a caller... a person in the chat room that sent me a question for a doctor here. Doctor, how are you doing today, Dr. Livingston?
I'm doing without and getting quite used to it. How are you doing today, brother
you
man?
You are very familiar in that sense then.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Livingston, one of our listeners had sent me a message on the internet, and they had a question. They wanted to know if you would explain hemophilia to them. Hemophilia.
Hemophilia?
Yeah.
Well, to me, it's getting very, very cold. I mean, you know, you get icicles on you, and it sets in another dimension of hemophilia. I'm going to have to pass on that. You might think that it's if your temperature is wrong, that means that you're cold, and it's set up homothermia. And then, as you get that thermia, you find that it's frozen. And you might lose that limb. It's called gangrene.
And then at the green, you find that hemophilia, which is the other side of getting your arm cut off. You still got bad character about yourself. You ain't healed yet. And it's called hemophilia.
Okay, yeah, I thought homophobia was you're scared of gay people.
Yeah, homophobia, yeah.
Oh, that's hemophilia, yeah. Yeah. I thought hemophilia, don't you have an aunt hemophilia?
No, tell me what hemophilia is.
Hemophilia is what helps you clot, you know, when you get a bruise or a scab. And you know, I thought you knew that, doctor.
Hemophilia is getting a scab on a wound.
Yeah, like if a plant is on strike.
It's called a scabby.
And when a plant goes on strike and you go to work, you're a scab. And if it scabs over too much, then the fluidity...
You're talking about a skank.
Profitability seems to sneak out the back door.
That's a skank. Skank, look like a scab. Yeah.
The same as a crab.
Yeah.
When you got a skank, you get the crab.
Now, I'm getting lost.
Now, pay your tab.
Hemophilia?
Yeah, it's just a very sad state of affair where your blood just can't seem to clot good and it leaks in everywhere. And that's a hemophilia. That's your medical...
Public service address announcement of the day
from Dr. Livingston.
Is something
who knows
missing
all.
In the blood clot? I mean, the blood system. Does it have enough?
What's your nickname, Sickle Cell?
My nickname is Killerman.
Attention, Cleveland area creditors. Are you tired of dealing with debtors that owe you money? I'm Jeff Renfro, and I've owned and operated Financial Recovery, a debt recovery specialist here in my hometown of Cleveland for 18 years. We're a licensed and bonded Tennessee collection agency working for a wide variety of creditors from commercial, manufacturing, physicians, dentists, attorneys, small business owners, to individuals. Look, any kind of business dealing with billing, charge accounts, or even return checks. I know your past due accounts are not a top priority for you, but they would be to me. Let me try to make it easy for you to make a change in the way you've been handling your accounts. There's no contract and no cost to you in most cases, as our fee of only 30% can be added to the balance owed to you. So, whether you have hundreds of accounts monthly and need help with your billing and collection, or you're just an individual and somebody owes you money, let me help you. Give me a call at 400-5376 and I'll come by and see you. That's 400-5376.
Financial Recovery, a licensed and bonded collection agency in Cleveland, Tennessee, 400-5376.
Rent to own. Hey, my Clevelanders, it's Fro. If you need to fill up some rooms in your home, but you don't have a lot of dough, go see my friends at Economy Rentals for a washer and dryer set for only $19.95 a week, or two rooms of furniture for your living room and bedroom for only $39.95 a week. Hey, 35 years in business, Economy Rentals is Cleveland's oldest family-owned rent-to-own store. Free delivery and setup. Economy Rentals. Rent-to-own? Make it easy to own. Inventory reduction sale. Hey, mention you heard it on Whoop and get 10% off all bedding. Economy Rentals. That's 901 Sahara Drive or call 472-6105. Visit them on the web at economyrentals.net. 901 Sahara Drive or 472-6105.
Mustang Sally now, baby. Oh, no.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the weather, you know, from our own chief meteorologist live here in the studio at approximately 11 minutes before the hour 5 on our own Viper 3D radar. It's our chief meteorologist, Randall S. Jarrett. Randall, how's that weather report?
Nah.
I see you're eating. I'm sorry, but you gave me the thumbs up. You were ready to give the weather report.
I dropped my denture. Hold on a minute.
You got dentures, too.
Yeah, man.
Alrighty now, here we go, loop-de-loo.
Good evening. This is Randall Jarrett, the weather meteorologist, right? Not the weather or a traffic guy.
Can I put that right there?
Yeah, go ahead. I don't care where you put it.
We're live. Like chocolate?
I didn't know if you knew this, but we're live on the air and we're giving our weather report right now.
Do you like chocolate?
Well, I used to, but I'm married.
I did. Oh, you do? He was an evil man. Well, anyway, I'd like to say good evening now, ladies, gentlemen, horses, mules, and bald-headed babies.
Where did Tamisha go?
How y'all doing out here today? Well, Cleveland Ayers, what about this weather? You know, I walked out of one building, it was cold, and then walked outside, it was warmer than it was on the inside. I guess I just had a cookie crumble sometimes. But, Cleveland Ayers, as this weather predicts itself to go on and do what it has to do, I have a prediction. And mine stands exactly like it is, it says in the newspaper. You know, today it called for a high today of 63 degrees, and I'll be danged if we didn't make it. But you know what? Believe it or not, our low is going to be 53 tonight. And beside all that, we only have about 50% chance of rain. Well, looking into Thursday, year-ends, we have another 50% chance. With our highs tomorrow being a little bit warmer than it was today, 65 degrees. This is tomorrow, year-ends, 65 tomorrow, man. You know, that is really kind of weird this time of year, isn't it? But most of the time, we get a Christmas of 65. But we was lucky on this Christmas, we was down to freezing. But anyway, you're in. Well, excuse me. We are going to be low tomorrow night. It's going to be down to 55 tomorrow night. Our high is 65 tomorrow. And again, repeating myself at the risk of being free. Tonight, y'all, it's going to be down about, it's going to drop down somewhere in the neighborhood of 53 degrees tonight. And what about this warm spring, y'all? I mean, it's coming out from the south, which we love. Anytime we got that flag blowing north, that's a good thing most of the time. The biggest 80% of the time is a good thing. And that's what about living so close to the Cape Peninsula, as we do. We can count on that warm breeze coming out of the south and hitting us and making us feel quite at home. And, of course, the weather's been like this for many moons has passed. But this is the weather, and that's how the cookie crumbles. But as long as that wind comes out of the south, I don't think we mind too much at all. But Cleveland Ayers, we're going to look into Friday. That's when the bad news is going to be hitting us, y'all. I hate to tell you, but it's going to start getting a little cooler on Friday. So today and tomorrow, go ahead and enjoy it while you have a chance. Come Friday, you might have a pleasant evening Friday, but Friday night, then that's when the nightmare will begin again. We're going to go back into a freeze. So hang in there, the best is yet to come. But as I'm trying to say is, we do have some rain, about a 65% chance of rain Friday, I think it is. We have another 50% chance tomorrow. So we got some rain coming in. It'll probably come in late Thursday night is what I'm predicting. And it's going to be quite interesting. And then it won't last long. And then Saturday, we're going to be a little chilly on the chilly side. But anyway, I won't cross the line of scrimmage until it's time.
Speaking of chili, Randall, I brought Matador some chili 2 days ago, and he never ate it. Would you like to take some home with you today?
I have some chili.
Oh,
chili
really?
Chili has already went.
Well, I have some for Randy. Randall, our meteorologist, Matador, and he might take some home since you didn't eat yours.
What are you talking about?
Oh, my God.
You done lost your mind.
Go ahead, everybody. This is your own chief meteorologist, Randall S. Jarrett, with most accurate Friday County.
Pat him up, Poop Man.
For some reason, we're still on the air.
All righty, man.
Go ahead, caller. You're live on Whoop. Okay, he left a message. Matador, somebody called in. They just keep calling. It just goes to voicemail.
I hope it's Sweet Dreams and Fly Machines.
No, we're not talking to Sweet Dreams anymore.
Man, I gotta have somebody close to my age.
No, she don't bring you no corn dogs.
No, she
can suck the chocolate off your nuts.
No, I mean, they gonna do jawbreakers tonight.
All right, go ahead, call your live. Hello.
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 Hello,
Chief. Is the Munchkin there today?
Yep, he brought the Munchkins in.
Hey, Kung Fu Louie. How you doing, you big ape? Very well, thank you.
I'm going to come down and aggravate you.
Well, let's do fine. I told Fro Daddy I'm just going to surprise you in about 6 weeks after I get fit. I'm going to give you a run for the roses.
Fit?
I'm going to give you a run for the roses.
You can't even spell fit.
Yeah, you know, I'm going to tell you what a fit is. So when you come down here 6 weeks from today, I'm going to be prepared to meet you, you big ape, and we're going to have a good time then. There'll be no gouging in the eyes, no sticking with pencils. Just me and you, you big ape, one-on-one.
I'm probably about ready to go back to work. He's been off for about 3 months.
Yeah, I heard about that, man. What's the matter?
I'm on doctor's orders, you know.
Oh, bull.
Like Maddor. Well, Maddor can't work every day. That's why he comes in here and sleeps.
Well, I guess that's why you're going to have to hire me, Kung Fu Louie.
Well, whoever does the job, I don't care.
Well, I don't mind working for you, even though you are a rhinoceros. But I don't mind.
Maybe somebody's passing up all that free work.
Yeah, free work it is. Well, you got some rain coming your way in a little while.
I need my horoscope, and I'm going to hang up. Listen.
All right, we got it right there.
Hey, boy, you sober today or something? That boy's sober.
No, I'd say he's not sober. Okay. That's why he's hanging up and just listening.
He's acting like he got good sense.
He's just going to hang up and listen to his horoscope. All right, there's TDL calling in. You know, Matador, he is a Aries. Speaking of Aries, I saw Aries' brother the other day working at Gondolier, as a matter of fact. Zoe. I know you don't know what I'm talking about, so I'll try to hurry on.
Carry on.
Aries. You know, it is Horoscope Hump Day, and this is the first horoscope we've done today. I think people forget. Hey, we'll do Maybe Babies. I think she's listening to us. Says she's walking around the track down in Chattanooga somewhere and listening to us on her iPhone. Aries, rely only on facts that you can verify, not hearsay. Take your position seriously and only make decisions that have been well thought out. Hard work will pay off. So don't give up before you get started. Like Matador, he wakes up in the morning and does that Superman roll, looks over and looks at SpongeBob and says, Lord, I'm laying back down. Ain't no point in getting up making money for this fat girl.
Hey, why you do that?
Because she's big-boned.
Well, that's right.
Let's do Maybe Baby. She's down there in the big city.
Hey, Maybe Baby.
Matador, do you know what she is?
She's spicy.
Yes. How small brain stem you have still holds.
Well, I don't know anybody else besides the chicken of the sea. Yum, yum, yum.
And Pisces is chicken of the sea. Okay, whatever you say.
Okay.
We call it something else up here.
Calvin Klein.
For Maybe Baby. And let's see, do we know any other Pisces so they don't have to call in? No, you know, Redhead Wildcat, she was Pisces, but she has passed on to the other side. So this one goes out to Maybe Only. Personal alterations will pay off and make you feel good. See, she's altering her body by walking around a track, making her feel good. I tell you what makes me feel good, crack cocaine. Dedication to a cause and using your powers of persuasion to get others to pitch in will make you a welcome candidate for advancement. Romance is highlighted. And not you, Mr. Bombastic, Mr. Fantastic.
That's my mating call.
Mr. You don't know what
that is. That's my mating call, boy.
Yeah, okay. You forgot completely what I'm talking about.
Mating call.
Yeah, well, we used to do the lyrical gangsta, but you don't know what I'm doing. We're going out here. It's just a few minutes before 5. Before we do our traffic report, we might try to throw another song in or two. What do you got, Matador? What do you want to hear?
I want to hear Mr. Bogard. Mr. Magic.
I've never heard of Mr. Bogard.
Mr. Magic Man. Mr. Bogard. Fantastic.
No, now you remember. Fro Daddy, you're live.
What's up, Fro, man?
Chucka G.
Chucka Boom.
What you want? We got 2-3 minutes.
Give us a horoscope.
Horoscope, kids.
Who? Oh, horoscope.
Horoscope.
I thought it was
all
a
right,
periscope.
Big.
You know, my daughter Chuck from G-Town, he is a Scorpio because me and him had the same birthday.
Hey, Buddha.
And I'm a Scorpio Fro. You know what a Scorpio Fro is?
Yes, that means spray.
That's a man with a long, pointy tail with a stinger on the end.
I got you now, brother.
Emotions will lead the way, and unique ideas and plans can be set into motion. Plan a trip or make positive adjustments to your lifestyle. Healthy activities will push you in a positive direction. romance is highlighted. Oh, I hope my wife's not listening. Hey, you know, it says I'm going on a trip. Chuck E. G., I'm going somewhere in about a month. So, hell, it's mine and yours horoscope.
It's about time for me to take one, too.
I take a trip every night. Oh, a little shot of liquor and a couple beers. Woo! Now, all right, then. What you want to hear? Hell, we'll try to get a song on.
Just play me something that you like.
Something I like?
Yeah.
My God, I'll do it right now and take us up at 5 o'clock.
All right, man.
Peace out, Chuck E. G-Town. Bye-bye. Hey, Matador, Chuck G. has waived his authority of asking for a certain request or to request a song. He said, I can do what I like. I mean, what I want to hear. So you know what I want to hear? You know what I feel like, man? I need to calm down because you've been on my damn last two nerves. I want to hear some Luther. Luther, just go eat something and leave me alone. No, Luther Vandross. I'm going to ask you to be quiet, please.
I ain't said a word, brother man.
You sound like that Chinese guy that calls in. It's the one bunda 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 bunda. It's the bunda bunda bunda. Unda bunda bunda bunda. In the bunda bunda. So here's a little thing, Matador. I can't ever get too much of Luther. Poor old Luther. Another one we lost a long time ago. Go eat a piece of candy. You're getting on my nerves. Here you go, Chuck E. G. Town. I can't help myself, but I don't want nobody else to help me. Oh, I'm sorry. I was just singing.
Be right back. Don't want to mess the Luther up.
Try to say how much I love you, Matador, but I can't stop. You're just too short for me to touch you. You're like a chocolate shining star on my commode doo-doo.
I can't fool myself, I don't want nobody else to ever love me. You are my shining star, my guiding light, my love fantasy. There's not a minute, hour, day or night that I don't love you. You're at the top of my list cause I'm always thinking of you. I still remember in the days when I was scared to touch you. How I spent my day dreaming, planning how to say I love you. You must have known that I had feelings deep enough to swim in. That's when you opened up your heart and you told me to come in. Oh, my love. A thousand kisses from you is never enough. I just don't wanna stop. Oh, my love. Never too much. Woke up today, looked at your picture just to get me started. You up that you weren't there and I was broken hearted. Hung up the phone, can't be too late, the boss is so demanding. Open the door up and to my surprise there you were standing. Who needs to go to work to hustle? I'd rather be with you cause you make my heart scream and holler. Love is a gamble and I'm so glad that I am winning. We've come a long way and yet this is only the beginning. A thousand kisses from you is never enough. Too much. I just don't wanna stop. Oh,
at my door.
Oh, my love.
Damn, you're right on there. You good. Man, you real good. Have I told you how much a good singer you is?
My teeth is hurting. Thank you.
I'm so sorry.
My whole head is hurting.
I'm so sorry about
Come
your
on,
dad.
Curtis Mayfield.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'm gonna do Doc Hollywood's and Matador's horoscope. Since nobody else called in, how about Cancer, Moon Children? You know, funny that Matador's horoscope sign is Cancer, seeing as how he's had 6 fingers, 1 cod, 2 tongues, a half a lung, and a gonad taken off for cancer.
Shutter.
And he's over there making fart noises for some reason. I guess to cover the real ones. Cancer, Matador, here's your horoscope. And Doc Hollywood's. Mm-hmm. It's only 2 cancers, I know. Except Doc's a pretty good guy, and you're more like a growth.
Planet from the...
You're more like a cancerous growth on my skin.
You're like poison ivy.
Yeah, I'm like poison ivy.
It make you itch, it make you bumpy.
Okay, are you going to listen to your horoscope?
Yeah, let it go.
Socialize and explore new interests. You know, like, don't go straight from here home and start drinking at home and get up and come straight back here for work tomorrow. Your creative imagination will be in overdrive. Whoa, does your mini bike have 3 gears?
Sure do.
Sparkling all sorts of ideas. Uh-huh. Give me an example. What idea do you have already?
Right now, I've got a condom that is created by...
Oh, a full-body condom.
No, it's called a rag mop is what we call it, and it secretes lamb oil out when in use.
Your imagination goes beyond belief.
Share
your thoughts, but not on my show. Collaborate and be open to partnerships, preferably with somebody of the opposite sex.
Yes.
Children will offer unusual insight. Oh, my God, why do I read yours? Stay away from children, please.
Look out,
children. Love and romance will improve your personal life, preferably with a human being, I hope.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, that's your horoscope.
I wonder what's wrong with Planet of the Apes.
I don't know, but yours fit perfect. Doc's didn't go for the doc. Hey, it's that time, folks. I got them on the radio. Here they are, your traffic reporter, once a day here about 5 o'clock while you're trying to drive home. We try to get you home while you listen to us in the car and get you the safest, quickest way home. No matter where you live in this county, we got you covered here on the Whoop Copter from our co-pilot, Roger, and our high-in-the-sky traffic reporter, Randy. Hey, Randy, how's that traffic going?
Hey, good evening now, Pro. How y'all doing now?
Tell us all about it.
Well, Pro, right now, buddy, we're up in Adam right now. We're out here on the north end of town, and we're just about ready to come on in and head to the south side of town, I guess you could say.
You mean from one Walmart to the other?
Open your mouth. I've seen a fly in it. But anyway, right about now, y'all, we're up in Adam right now. We're leaving the Bradley Square Mall. We're in that area right now, and we're looking over Wally World, and it looks like...
Did you say the Bradley Square Mall or the Bradley Square Mall?
The Bradley Square Mall.
It's only for old white people that walk the mall.
Well, whoop-a-doo. They know what we're talking about, but anyway, you're in... Here we go. Well, we're flying over the, I guess you can call it Wally World right about now. And Wally World, they always keep a nice little heaping of traffic out there, I'm telling you. And we're going to go ahead and hit the main artery of traffic at this time, and we're going to come on down Keith Street. Well, Keith Street also is looking divine. The traffic is moving right on along, it seems like it is. And nice, moderate speed right now. Everybody seems to abide by the rules and regulations of the driving. And looks good from here. Now we're going to go ahead and hit 25th Street, Urins. And we're going to go up 25th Street and see what we got going on up in that area. It looks like the traffic is moving very well up through there also. Looking real good. We don't see any accidents or any broken down automobiles in the middle of the street. Everything seems to be moving right along, Urins. All right, we're going to G-turn now, and we're going to head on back down toward the Village Green as we hit the corner of East Street. And here we go, loop-de-loo. We're going to fly over the Village Green right now. There they go, loop-de-loo. All right, y'all, it's looking good. Now we're just about ready to go ahead and hit Dalton Pike and see what they got going on in that neck of the woods. Well, I don't know what the deal is, but it seemed to be simplified. It seemed like they're just moving right on along steady as they go down Dalton Pike, Urins. That's looking good. As we make another G-turn, me and the helicopter brothers, we're going to go ahead and fly over to Wally World and see what we got going on. It seems like right now they got the traffic moving over in that area quite sufficiently, moderately, and easy taking times, please. And this is looking good, too, right about now out there at Wally World on the south side of town. Yes, it does. So far, we don't see any wrecks, no red lights or anything without substance. Everything seemed to be moving right along, Urens. And I'm going to hold two thumbs up today, Pro Daddy. It looks honky-dory out there.
All right, honky-dory coming at you straight out there from the honky, high in the sky pilot himself, or what am I talking about?
Well, I tried to bite this and didn't have a thing. That's bad.
Okay, Matador, I'm still on the air with
I forgot.
All right there, Randy, our high in the sky reporter. Our high in the sky reporter up there with our drunk pilot Roger in the co-pilot seat, whatever, the whoop copter. That is our beautiful award-winning traffic reporter every afternoon from our colored commentator, Randy.
Did you say colored?
Yeah, he's our colored commentator.
Well, I've never in my life heard such a thing.
Oh, they say that all the time on sports shows. You know, the guy that sits next to the other guy and tells him stuff like...
And he's a colored dick?
Yeah, tell him we're high in the sky. You know, tell him it's number 72 was, you know. Yeah, he's called the colored commentator.
Oh, well, that's cool. I can buy that, Drew.
Cool.
Well.
Anyway, we got every song on, all the requests on. We got Maybe Baby, a little Mustang Sally. We got Chuck from G-Town wanting me to whatever I want to hear. I heard some Luther Vandross.
Oh,
you know, we've heard all kinds of stuff today, man. Some of the folks going into the blues.
Yeah.
No matter what you call it, the Sanctioned Blues Association or whatever it is.
Oh,
let's go ahead, caller. You're live.
Of course.
Try to speak clearly if you could there, caller.
Go ahead. English.
somebody just fell off the water tower over here in Cleveland. Sorry about that.
Right, go ahead, caller. You're live.
Try to call us back when your aluminum foil helmet comes back on.
Aluminum foil head. Go ahead.
That reminds me, Matador, are we going to have any lightning when these storms that are coming in late tonight and tomorrow? Because I was going to get you that new aluminum foil helmet I bought you.
No, we just always put on some clothes hangers.
Yeah, you were born with clothes hangers in your nose, so I guess you'll be all right. What?
That was a yellow belly sad sucker sound.
Oh, I thought maybe a little boy was walking by going.
Oh, yeah, there. Yeah. Well, you know, we kind of we repeat ourselves at the risk of being free.
I repeal you.
I repel me too. This pain that I got in my mouth. What happened on along the way?
I know what I was going to do. Dr. Livingston's walking out there. I guess he's getting ready to leave, so I'm going to try to get him in here before he leaves out of here, Matador.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to try to get Dr. Livingston in here and see if he can get his attention. There you go. Hey, come on in. Hey, Doc. Yeah, him and Reverend Seymour back in the back. They come in here and use our stuff on Wednesday afternoons and get ready for their group therapy and anger management classes and their blessing of the Whoopsters from where do y'all do it now? Where do you go? Over to the Southside Church?
We go to United Methodist Church of God. Did I say it right?
The United Methodist Church of God?
Yeah.
Where is that? I've never seen that.
Well, that's on the south side of town. It's out in Langton Road.
Oh, Langton Road. Yeah,
okay, miss it.
All right, well, hell.
Let's go down APD 4.
Hey, Dr. Livingston, come on in. Hey, Dr. Livingston, how you doing, man?
Hello, Doc. How you doing?
How you doing, Doc? Come on in and get in with Mike over there. Hey, Dr. Livingston. I saw Reverend Seymour out there. You guys getting ready for tonight? Doctor, are you okay, Doc?
Who are you?
Oh, hey, Dr. Livingston. Hey, we had a couple of two or three email questions this week at my email address to ask Dr. Livingston.
Mm-hmm.
And so I wanted to hurry. I'm going to hurry. I know you're in a hurry to get to your Southside Methodist over there mm-hmm. for the jurisdiction of Sixth Ward. And before you go, though, are y'all having fish fry?
Well, we'd have one every Friday. Which would be Saturday. They usually have it for the...
Yeah, with the bald-headed baby.
Yeah, to help us out during the holidays.
Here's one of our listeners that chatted to me on the internet at frodaddy@whoopfm.com. Mm-hmm. Anytime you have a medical question or a song request or anything, always call FRODADDY. Mm-hmm. I mean, email me, FRODADDY.
And repeat.
FRODADDY at whoopfm.com. That's FRODADDY at WOOPFM.com. You can email me, you know, naked pictures. You can email me a song request. You can email me nude pictures. Did I say that?
Right? Yeah,
you can email me song requests, Dr. Livingston questions, Matador questions, anything you need to know here, anything about any of our sponsors. If you have a question, what's their phone number, just email that to me and we'll get back to you the next day. Doctor, I've got three for you. Here's my first one. Dr. Livingston, why does my mouth sometimes itch after I eat nuts?
What?
Well, I'm sorry, let me rephrase that. Why does my mouth sometimes itch after I eat fruit or nuts?
Well, listen, Pooh, either you're allergic to it, or the fruit just don't like you. Repeat?
That's it? Well, why does it itch, though?
Don't you understand? You're allergic to it. Some people itch and they scratch. You got a scratch in your mouth, but it's itching. And you can't do nothing, but you can't scratch it, but you can brush your teeth, and maybe brush it would be a scratch for you.
Okay. Yeah, because I was thinking, you know, like there's proteins in like raw produce and nuts. There are like allergens, like ragweed, tree pollen. You know, if you have hay fever, you might get an allergic reaction to raw foods like carrots and apples and nuts.
Who you calling a nut?
But I was thinking, you know, if you cook them, they wouldn't cause those symptoms. So if you're cooking your fruits and vegetables, or if you have nuts, you know, pine nuts and so on, maybe pan sear them, you know, bake them in the oven, your nuts. Put your nuts in the oven, get them hot. And if you like chocolate salty nuts, you might want to melt those in a bowl first and get the chocolate off and then put them in the oven and bake them. Anyway, Dr. Livingston, thank you so much for answering that question.
They're not noted. Some people don't like salt and chocolate mixed. Well, it has to be the right measurement. Too much of one will destroy the other.
So what's worse, chocolate or saltiness?
Well, I'd say the salt is more or less it can draw a snail up, because you can imagine what it could do to you. Another untold story. Next page, please. Have you ever been mellow? Have you ever tried before?
You talking about weed?
Mellow.
Mellow?
Mellow.
I've been mellow before.
Well, good for your problem.
Well, thank you, Maddo. Anyway, since I got Dr. Livingston in here, we've got him in here. I got Dr. Livingston just for a few more minutes. We had two more internet emails to me. FroDaddy@WhoopFM.com. Here's my next one. My daughter, somebody, it says here, please tell me they think they may have skin cancer, Dr. Livingston. It says here, please can Dr. Livingston tell me the signs and symptoms that might indicate if I have skin cancer. Can you help us with that, Dr. Livingston?
Well, if you notice, if you have skin cancer, it's going to be very, very sore. If you get very, very sore, and somehow it seeps, gets to a pulsatile stage, that's a boil. A boil is usually caused by, a hair follicle. Now, what you want to do is go ahead and see your physician and make sure that it's okay. I'm sure that it's sore right now, but maybe you want to get you some kind of tonic and rub on it a little bit. Probably try something without a greasy base. Try something like an aftershave or just plain alcohol and rub it on it and see if it burns you. If it turns black, you have skin cancer. If it turns real, real dark, it's a skin cancer involved in that, which can be treated with the medication.
Dr. Livingston, no offense, but what if the person that was asking this question was a dark person when they can't see the dark spots?
Well, if it's a dark person, it comes to a pulsatile stage, I guess you could say. It does basically the same thing. Just because their skin is darker, that doesn't mean that the skin pigment does not secrete a certain smell from the skin, which is called bromidoris. That will, if it has a bromidoris type smell, that just be secreted from that wound on their skin. But it's rare that a dark complexion person to get a skin sun cancer or skin cancers. It's usually maroon within.
Okay, well, there you go. A pustule stage, whether you're white or black, look for pus coming out of your body, and you may have skin cancer. Thank you, Dr. Livingston.
Well, wait a minute. Check it out.
Go ahead and explain a little further. I'm sorry, did I say it
right? No, that's okay. We should have made a G turn when you didn't say it quite right.
I'm sorry. Well, I don't want to tell any of our listeners wrong. Anything you say, I'm sorry. Please, go ahead.
Just see your physician and tell him the same thing that you were telling me, that it burns. Okay, you got it. Okay, retreat, y'all. Retreat. Go back to your positions and hold it steady.
Okay, Dr. Livingston, before I know you, I see Reverend Seymour's waving at you. You guys are running a little late, and I do thank you for sticking around. Man, we usually don't have any questions, but we just happen to have three. So let me get this last one in here. It says they just sent it to frodaddy@whoopfm.com. A question for Dr. Livingston. Here you go, Dr. Livingston. My doctor said I may have nomophobia. Could you please tell me more about that, what it is? When that, I was in there, I'm sorry, my 16-year-old son, I took him to the doctor. It seems he was very nervous. His eyes were twitchy. His fingers were jittery. And we went in there before school the other day, and the doctor there said, well, your son may have nomophobia. Nomophobia. Dr. Livingston, I've never heard of that. What is that?
Nomo, that means it's nomophobia. What it was, his reactions to like a snack or a peanut butter, his reactions were somewhat basically the same. His nomophobia. Because it would make him usually go into, I guess you could say, a flip the script mood, so to speak.
Like off the chain?
You get off the chain, off the hook kind of thing.
Yeah, like a fish off the hook, yeah.
So that means he don't have nomophobia. That means he all right now.
Oh, so the symptoms he was having when she took him in there, she can just ignore that he really has nomophobia.
Right, he's good to go.
Okay, because they sent me another follow-up and said the fear of being without your cell phone. It's a particular anxiety children have when they're used to having their phone with them. When they leave and forget it, they have nomophobia. But that sounds like the same thing you said, and you're always correct here, and we always know to put pine needles under our rectum when we're having diarrhea.
Well, he nomophobia me, brother.
Thank you, Dr. Livingston. And there you have it, folks. Thanks, Dr. Livingston. Goodbye, and see you, Dr. Reverend Seymour.
Well, all right.
Madora, we got a few more minutes left here on the show. And a few more minutes left on the show.
I ain't got time for this, man.
Yeah, you're starting to cut out a little earlier every day. I'm going to have to turn you in for leaving early.
That's because my mouthpiece got tore out somehow.
It's probably all that food you eat every day on the show.
You think so?
Pretty sure, yeah.
Well, in fact, of course, the flu's like we do. Sometimes we get it in the mouth, sometimes it's in the eyes, and sometimes it's in your head. I guess it all depends.
Hey, we got a caller. Go ahead, caller.
Hey,
Sid, go ahead. Hey, Sid, how you doing? All right.
I'm late.
Oh, yeah, gosh, we were worried about you.
I come in tired on the radio, and y'all come in clear as a bell.
Well, thank goodness you got that new radio, because I got tired of you blaming it on us.
Then what happened?
No, I pushed memory in everything went berserk, and I lost it.
Sid, Mandor, what's he saying? I don't understand what he's yelling at me.
Speak English, please.
Speak English. Come on, sir. Monsieur beaucoup. Okay. Pully pussy, point say, what say?
Yeah, speak English.
Chiquita, Pinoza.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so your radio's good. What else can we do for you?
Grande titties.
Big titties.
I went to Lowe's and got me a...
new radio, huh?
No. I got a...
filter for your... Did you get a filter for that water pump that was coming straight from that black girl's apartment?
Yeah, it's in your nose. No, my phone.
I got me a good antenna. I ain't got it hooked up yet in there.
I'd say that's the least of our troubles right now.
Yeah.
What can I do for you, Sid?
Oh, also, one thing, and I want to ask Dr. Livingston something.
You're not joking.
Heard of him?
Dr. Livingston's already gone. Hey, Sid, Dr. Livingston's already gone, but Mandor's here. He'll answer your question.
Yeah, he said don't jump. Now, what is the question?
Have you ever heard of hoof and mouth disease?
Yeah, Mandor's got it.
No, what does that do?
That's where you put your foot in your mouth and you roll around in circles with your clothes off.
Now, tell me what it is, Sid.
Mandor caught it from a cow when he was trying to milk a bull.
What is something like shit, piss, and fall back in it?
Okay. What else can I do for you, Sid?
Well, here we are, soap, bro.
Okay.
Now, give me the soap.
And then hook up my antenna here in a little bit.
All right, Sid. Mandor, Sid is a vegetarian.
Sagittarius.
So, Sagittarius. Sid, don't disclose where you keep your valuables or personal information.
Uh-oh.
Try to be a good listener to avoid being asked questions you probably shouldn't answer.
Ooh.
Intelligence and information are powerful tools when negotiating. In other words, if she wants $10, you say, I give you $7.
Do not let her mess with the guitar.
What else can we do for you? We're out of here.
I got $50,000, $100,000 renter's insurance.
Okay, well, good.
Insurance.
Let's burn that mother down and have a party.
That horoscope suit.
All right. Hey, Sid, thank you, buddy. We'll hear you tomorrow.
Too many pictures showing.
Well, why is it? Don't forget, we'll be seeing you Friday.
I got too many pictures showing on my page, you know?
Yeah, don't give anybody your cell phone. You're going to jail.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm talking about...
Is that who?
Damn, I ain't got no naked pictures.
Oh, hell. In that case, we're hanging up on you.
Well, it'll give you phone virus.
Okay. Matador got a virus. Matador's got every virus known to man.
I have one to a monkey.
One a monkey even gave him.
I beg your pardon, well, brother man.
We have a Samuqua.
You they big ape.
Put Sid, 30 seconds, Sid. 30 seconds.
Pretty women wanting to be friends. Real, real pretty women.
30 seconds.
Wanting to be friends.
All right, Sid. No, you tell us all, but take pictures of them naked, send them. We'll tell them it's okay.
Well, one woman got banned from Facebook.
Yeah. Well, hell, she's probably real ugly anyway.
For taking naked pictures of herself.
Well, that's terrible.
Well, what was she thinking?
Or she should have taken them down here to the radio station. I got to go, Sid. Thanks for calling in, though.
Yeah.
We'll see you tomorrow.
I thought you were... Bye.
Okay, bye. Sid, Matt Dory, anything you want to... Any final words you want to say here?
Ooh.
Before we make like a sewer and get the... out of here. Hmm?
No.
None? Okay, well... We have one more caller. Let's take a caller. Go ahead, caller.
I've had a call for a long time since you got your request with Luther Vandross.
Hey, mister.
What's called Chris?
You got a who?
There he is.
You got to do what?
The horoscope, buddy.
Oh, matter of what's Mystery Man's horoscope sign?
He's a Sagittarius.
No, Sid was.
Okay.
Aquarius. How soon we forget, Matador? Mr. Man, Aquarius, it's okay to be secretive with regard to your plans. Being prepared will make a difference to the outcome. Someone's emotional negativity will put a dent in your progress. Avoid unnecessary communication and travel. Ooh, it's the Mystery Man.
Ooh, the Mystery Man can.
Because the Mystery Man makes it fun. All right, Mystery, see ya.
Avoid all travel.
Bye. He started to yell something, but we got to go. Tell everybody goodbye, Matador. You got anything you want to end up with? We've had Reverend in here. We've learned about some blues artists that are up for awards. We heard people dying. We've got you know what I thought was funny? I saw in the news. Did you see this stuff? This is great. The city of New York City, I might add, is a little easier to say it. They're suing. The city of New York is suing the five major oil companies, claiming they are contributing to global warming.
Oh, sure.
So the city of New York is taking over as far as, if anybody's going to do it, why wouldn't it be Washington, D.C.? What the hell has the city of New York got to do with taking over for the global warming of the world? And they're going to blame it on just the five major oil companies.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there you go, folks. Be careful what you're doing. You can be sued for anything, even if you're a oil company or just a kid mowing the yard nowadays. Don't fall on anybody's grass or trip on something and sue the whole family forever. And glory to be and glory to Jesus and walk through the valley of the shadow of death. And yay, I love the golden streets of heaven and hell versus another eating Matador's food off the floor.
I beg your pardon.
Any other speeches you'd like to give, call us up right now.
I would like to say, please, find a place in your heart to forgive Fro Daddy and I at this time. We just want you to know without your love and your support, we are no good at all. Good night, Cleveland.
And Matador, you're not very good, period, but that's a whole other story.
I never intended to be.
I never begged your pardon. I never promised you a garden. I gotta go.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Don't forget, tomorrow's Thirsty Thursday. We'll be back tomorrow on Thirsty Thursday at 3:30 in the afternoon on the Fro Daddy Show. Tune in. Kids, it's 5:30. Time for me to rock on down, rock on down, rock on down the line. And it is hump day. What?
Uh-oh. Guess what day it is?
Julie.
That's right, kids. It's hump day, and it's time for me to rock on, Jacko. I'll leave you a little Dwight Yoakam here with some Prince cover. I like this one. Purple rain, purple rain. Go to know. We'll see you tomorrow on Thursday. Pro Day, know all, see all, mostly tell all.
Peace.
And this is Dwight Yoakam. That's right, country star, country artist, country singer, cowboy hat wearing, blue jean, cowboy boot toting, country ass redneck, singing Purple Rain by Prince. I hope you like it. Only on Whoop Radio.
Never meant to call you when I saw